What's going on, everybody, and welcome to part 17 of my playthrough for Fear Files Perseus Mandate. We've entered the vault, and there's no going back now. I mean, seriously, if none of that other stuff has deterred us from getting to this point, then nothing can stop us at this point, am I right? This place is interesting. Whoa. Oh god. Right or left, what do you think? Let's go right. Probably should have gone left. I don't think it matters, does it? At least the same place.
I have the DNA. Prepare for extraction.
What? Oh, I don't think so. Not on my watch, buddy. Oh man, he did pull the... Oh my gosh. Get back here. Shit. Man, what a jerk, right? It's like we're playing Mario Kart and he's in first place and tossing all these, like, bananas behind me. And the bananas have machine guns in them. That would be awesome if Mario Kart had that. I'm writing this down. We have... Ooh, jeez. Jerk. Guy's a jackass.
Fear can do better than you.
Oh... Crap. Be too easy if we could just pull the elevator back down, right? Oh my gosh, now we gotta, like, Mario our way back up top. Crud! Ugh! Can't even do that. Gotta wait for the elevator. Get back here. Man. Oh. Ooh. What have we here? Of course. I wouldn't have it any other way. Who built all this? Where are we? What is... Are they just, like, chilling? Is that what they do? Is that what supernatural beings from another dimension do? When they've entered your dimension, they just chill? What's up, guys? Interesting. Are those replica soldiers? Oh, guys, what's going on, guys? I missed you all. Hey, guys, what's up? Ah, a warm welcome. That's why I love you guys. I've missed you guys. You guys are the best. And you, the big guy with the armor. He thinks he's so tough. He's not so tough. He's fairly tough. You die. Uh-oh. There we go. I think he had a rocket launcher in his hands. Uh-oh. Woohoo! Oh, I've missed the replica soldiers. Like I said, fighting the Nightcrawlers is like a step up. And I like the challenge, but fighting these guys, he did not survive that. No. Fighting these guys is just like... What the hell? Okay. It's just nostalgic, you know what I mean? Like, I love these guys, I really do. It's like, you know, you're fighting Goombas all the time, then you get kind of tired of Goombas, and you get a new enemy in Mario or something, and you fight them for a really long time, and then you finally get sick of them, and you're just happy to see the Goombas again, you know what I mean? It's kind of like that. You're not going to open for me? Fine. Fine. It's okay. Oh, good thing there's just, like, health everywhere. But I really shouldn't complain about something like that, because you know what I mean? What if I didn't have it? Oh, man. Oh, that was very well hidden. I didn't see that there. Uh-oh. I was kind of hoping you could slam them in the back and they would die in one hit. I've never hit one of these guys in the back before. Oh, he's not happy about that. Uh-oh. Ooh. Out of my way. And then I can hear an automatic turret going off somewhere. This music is awesome. Like, they got the chase music going on. The bum 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 bum. Oh, shit. Back up, back up. Oh, crap. Oh, jeez. Woo! Is that door glitching out of me? Is he gonna follow me? Oh gosh. Ooh. Oh man. Two. Three. Is he dead? I can't even tell. It's so much smoke. Awesome. If only we get a shield, right? But hell, I'll take the minigun. I'm gonna pick this up for that. There we go. Yeah. Well, let's go around with this bad boy. And I love how like all the Nightcrawlers are dead now, and then we've got the Replica Soldiers back. I really like that. It's cool. Whoa, shit! That was a good move. I give you boys credit. That was a good move. No. Last thing he said. Shit. Exclamation point at the end of that. Keeping to my journal memoir. Cafeteria? Is that where we are? The cafeteria? No one saw that? No one saw me? Yeah, these guys are really not in the bar, are they? That's why I love you guys. Oh, you'd like that one. Just the one. Never mind. The sexual jokes sometimes are too easy. Uh-oh. Man, we are on a roll right now. Thank you for all the health packs. I mean, these are just scattered everywhere. Where'd that guy get to?
That is sending one of his tin men to kill me? Typical.
Tin man? I don't think you know who you're talking about, buddy. I have a lot of soul. Or don't. Man, there's a lot of stuff scattered around here. It almost looks like a boss room! Yeah! Gauntlet time. Come on, throw the rest of your dudes at me, right? I've killed most of them. How many guys do you really have? Aww. Oh, he took a lot of hits. I'm impressed.
Looks like I'm gonna have to do this myself.
Damn right. Where is he? Come on. Bring it on, head honcho. I'm not even being sporting to him right now. That turret is in a really good spot. Oh, shit. Jesus Christ. Goddamn. Oh, shit.
We got him.
Target marked.
Wait,
surround
what?
Him.
Oh, I don't think so. Say hello to my little friend. Oh my god, the carnage. Carnage. Can you imagine a guy with a machine gun just screaming carnage?
Stop them. You are a fool if you think this is over.
Oh, it's gonna be over. No. Christ! Woo! Oh man, this is getting epic. You guys feel this? One-on-one, mano-a-mano, head honcho versus me. Who will win? Where'd he go?
Yeah.
Shit. Whoa. Now I have the upper hand. Oh gosh. This is for all the innocent people you killed. This is for my buddy. And this. That one was for me.
Get topside once you've recovered the DNA.
Nighty night, crawler. Oh, see what I did there with the night crawler and the nighty night? You guys got it. I planned that one a couple minutes in advance. Let's just grab this and get out of here.
We've got Delta Force choppers inbound. Let's move.
Where have you been? Well, wait a minute. Hold on. Flabbergaster, did you just say Delta Force choppers? Are you telling me Delta Force is helping us? Oh, someone, the apocalypse has come. Delta Force is helping us. Oh, gosh, let's get the hell out of here. See what I mean about the shotgun before? It's like you're never going to run out of ammo for this thing. For real. Oh, man. Replica soldiers want to send us with one last goodbye, or am I right? Like, tossing all the stops, telling us who the real guys are. Those mercs, they were nothing. We're replica soldiers. Oh, shit. Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Now just the big dude. Oh, shit. Oh. Yeah. Woohoo. This is awesome. Don't you love it? Did he forget where I was? Oh, shit. Someone has their sensitivity on 10. Shit. Jesus. Yeah, I'm gonna peek my head out real quick in the middle of a firefight to see if I can see anything. Oh my god, they killed our guy. Oh my god, he's pointing his gun at me. Oh my god. I mean, really, right? I love these guys. Now we just can't end the game unless we have one of these in our hands. Oh, yes. Hey, guys. No. Oh. Crazy man comes walking out of the smoke. With one of these things? I mean, come on. Are we, I don't even know if I'm going the right way here. I don't even know where my buddy went. Where'd my buddy go? Did he, like, run past me? Like, see you later, man. Oh, sweet. There's stuff littered everywhere. Oh my god! Who put this stuff here? Am I right? Holy crap. Oh, there he is. Oh, boy. Oh, man. Showdown time. This is it. The home stretch. Nothing's gonna stop us now. Don't stop me now. Having such a good... Wait, didn't I make this reference at the end of Fear Files extraction point? Ah, whatever.
Yeah.
Oh! Jesus. Did you see that guy just take those hits? I gotta get... That guy deserves a medal right there. You know, on his gravestone. Where should I go? Oh my gosh. I mentioned how much I love the replica soldiers. And this is why I have this job. And probably right about now, these guys are questioning why they're out here trying to fight a guy. Trying to fight a crazy man who's blown his way through three armies and supernatural beings with a minigun. I mean, come on. Sometimes, if this game was in third person, do you know how cool I'd look? I gotta keep writing this stuff down for the movie, like the sunset, the helicopter background, the army, the minigun. Yeah, I can see it now. And that makes 100. Because I'm sure all of you are keeping count, right? Oh! That's right. Fear me. Yeah. I've been saving that one the whole game. Alright, let's get the hell out of here.
Yes. It's all over. It's all over now. Oh, man.
Son, team's gonna need a new lieutenant after this. I think Jen had wanted to be you.
And that is the end of Fear Files Perseus Mandate. Like I said, this was... I really enjoyed Fear Files Perseus Mandate. I've always enjoyed all the Fear series. It's one of my more favorite series. It's kind of a... Not like an indie series. It kind of has like a smaller fan base, so like a certain fan base that follows it. You know, it's repetitive at times. This one is obviously older. I don't see. I got the box right in front of me here. That does connect my two playthroughs though for Extraction Point and Perseus Mandate. That was fun. I enjoyed it. I like having to be able to come back to this game because of the two separate campaigns. And like I said, this game is really cheap right now. Like, you can find this for like $3. I'm not even kidding. Like less than that. And it's the two campaigns. You got this one and the Extraction Point, which you can watch if you hadn't. They kind of go coincide each other, but like I said, they're in different timelines. It's all very weird stuff. I could take hours explaining it, but Perseus Mandate, out of all the other Fears, Fear 1, Fear Extraction Point, Fear 2, Fear 3, Perseus Mandate is interesting. Just in the fact, like right there, that was actually the closest thing to a happy ending you can really get in a Fear game. I mean, seriously, usually most Fear games end with our plane blowing up and then we're doomed. Like, that's how it goes. But I really enjoy this. I like the difference of the replica soldiers versus the Nightcrawlers, just having the two different... They're similar, and yet the AI handles differently when you're fighting them. And they're, like, different personalities, so it's a really cool thing to have. And Perseus Mandate's story in general is cool because of the character you play as, the team you play as. The whole thing is different. And honestly, out of all the Fears, I felt like they nailed this one the best between going through different areas. I really felt like in all the other Fears, you run through the same area in the game. And this game, I felt like you really go through a lot of different areas. You're outside, you're on a roof, you're in a building, you're in an office, you're underground, you're in mines, you're in a facility. I feel like you do a lot. And in this game, you kind of have more of a neutral enemy with still a lot of supernatural stuff going on. The shades are great, the nightmares, and... Those creepy convulsing things, I can't think of what their names are right now, but they have official names, and I find those things to be the most creepy out of all because you never encounter them in combat. And I think they do a really good... They just do a good blend in this game of... You got action, you got story, you got supernatural fear that can't be explained, you got things that are creepy, you got darkness, you got more combat, you got story, you got characters, you got people you care about. They do a good job with that in Perseus Mandate. I think they nailed it more on the head than any of the other Fears. Extraction Point, Fear 1. Fear 2 was good, but I still feel like what Fear 2 and Fear 3 lacks is the enemies. In this game, like I said, you got the Nightcrawlers, you got the Replica Soldiers, which is awesome. And then you got the Supernatural Things, which is half of what Fear is. And I felt like Fear 2 and Fear 3 sort of lost that. Especially Fear 3, like I said, the Scarecrows. Awesome enemy. Really cool, really unique. Gives you a good jump. They're not traditional. You kind of got, like, it's your own fault. They're like a trap. And then you got things like the shades that run at you, the nightmares that force you into slow-mo for a second and portals ripped open. You know what I mean? You got things that you see once in a while looking at you. It's awesome. I love it. I really do. And that's why I think, I don't want to say anything, but, because I love the Fear series, but I think if I had to name one of the campaigns out of the Fear series, I think Perseus Mandate would be my favorite. And that's a pretty tall order for a guy like me, especially when you think about how obscure of a game Fear Files is. It came out at like a time where I think DLC, you know, nowadays we have full-on games for download, like you can download a full game, and this kind of came at a time where it's like that wasn't almost really a thing, and their DLC was like Fear Files, and I think it's a really cool and unique kind of, I mean, other games that did things like this where they had standalone discs that were like basically DLC to a main game. But I really like Extraction Point because really it's more of a full game itself. Regardless of the fact that it might be two half campaigns put together. I mean this was longer than I thought it was going to be. This, what do we have? We had like 17 parts here. 20 minutes to 15 minutes for all parts. That's a pretty good amount of length of gameplay. Not to mention there's more to the game. Oh yes, there's always more to Fear. And I really like this. This is a different point of view for the game. There's so many things are good about this. I really like everything about it. That's why I feel, if I had to say, like I said, I haven't played F.E.A.R. 2 in a while, and I still haven't played the F.E.A.R. 2 DLC. Like becoming, there's always more Horror Fest, right? But it's always been fun to play F.E.A.R. as part of October Horror Fest. That's how it started originally. My very first one, which was really just the sloppy mess of me playing a horror game, but I was having fun. That's why I loved it. That's why F.E.A.R. has always kind of been a staple mark on my channel, too. And one of the reasons I think I feel strongly about the game, and why I like to see it, you know, succeed with F.E.A.R. Origins now out and stuff going on with that, it's really cool. But yeah, this was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed this playthrough. I hope anyone who's still watching at this point also enjoyed it, because it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. I had a good time with it. Perseus Mandate was good. I remember just enough of the game to not be lost, but didn't remember just enough of the game to be freaked out once in a while, scared to be taken by surprise. So in that sense, it was enjoyable.
Remember, no one touches the source but me.
We've got Morrison.
Losses.
Acceptable.
Oh man, don't you guys just love cutscenes at the end of the credits? I do. Personally, I've sat through a couple credits now through some of my playthroughs, and I always love when there's an extra cutscene at the end. It makes the credits worth sitting through, and it's just kind of like a little cool Easter egg at the end. That's going to be the end of my playthrough for F.E.A.R. Files Perseus Mandate. Like I said, might just be my favorite F.E.A.R. game out of all of them, which is a big thing for me to say with all the other F.E.A.R. playthroughs I've done. But as always, F.E.A.R., it's a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the game, and I hope you guys enjoyed it too. But for now, this is going to be the end. So I thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you later.